Good morning, it is Monday again. August 6th, 2018, we are working on Spellventure Game Dev. Today we're going to be finishing up some work we were doing for a... For a Roll20 D&D Dungeons & Dragons kind of tile set that we're going to be using tomorrow. So let me see. I don't have it here. Welcome to the stat stream. Alright, let's see if we can get a crate here. Crate dot blend. We can do it here. Alright, so we have the crate. Okay, we're gonna open up Substance Painter because we're gonna actually make this pretty decent. Pretty decent. Substance Painter updates. I'll do that later on. I know I'll run into it later. Okay, so. Okay, we don't. There's a bunch of these that we don't need for this version. So here's what I'm going to do. So I'm just making this for Nicholas. It's gonna be a barrel, alright? Let me actually open this right here. Not even really warm yet, so that's great. We're gonna open up roll 20. Who knows, might actually be able to use this for an asset that we can make later and sell for a buck or two. So that's probably what we'll do. Although I will not save this one because the asset that I want that I was making earlier had the ability for a for the lid to open and close, which is very important, right? Because you can utilize that for just various game mechanics. Just barely fitting, sometimes not at all. It's okay if we're a little bit off, that's not a huge deal. okay, and then these go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's fine. I'm not going to save that. What I am going to do, however, this is wood. So we're going to materials. We're going to say wood and then metal, right? Bam, just like that. And then we're going to take these like that. So we're going to 3D cursor for both, right? That's the interior. We don't want that. We just want everything there. Alright, then we're going to export as FBX. We're going to go to D&D. We're going to go to FBXs. We're going to go so crates. Alright, then we're going to do this. Substance Painter. Bam. Export FBX. Now, X that out. Do not save. Go back to Substance Painter. Bring it in. Cool. Why would it do that? Go to log on to the center, please. Alright, now we're going to bake mesh maps, curvatures. Make sure the curvature is good. Bake all texture sets. The one thing I've noticed is that, you know, depending on the size, depending on what you're utilizing the model for, you don't not have to do this. Let me switch over to Unity. So this is what I'm working with here. The barrel and the crate are going to be kind of small. You know, they're going to be like these little pieces here. So you're not really going to be able to see them. But if it were a 3D game and we were inside the game, that'd be a different story. Okay, still begging. Alright, so back in 3D here. Got a little puddle there. This is pretty good. I got a barrel here somewhere, right here, barrel. So we got a little barrel. Okay, so what I'll do is go back to 2D. The barrel's right there, it's got the camera. A similar lighting scheme. Alright, so then I'm going and then I will take that and turn it off. Click on this. I don't want black. What I want is click on main camera. We're going to turn that color to like a bright green and then that'll do this. Alright, it'll give me a green that I can then use. We then use to edit out. FBX is textures. We're gonna go with barrel OBM. Right now we don't want that. We're gonna go with where are your world 20 tile sets? We're gonna go with barrel OBM. The rubble is probably okay. So I'm gonna redo that. There we go. Right there. Okay, we're gonna stick with that. Take that barrel out, we don't need it anymore. Cool, and then as you can see the darkness now, I've added ambient occlusion. You can actually see that here. Add ambient occlusion lines there, basically little shadows. It'll detect the lighting and add shadows. In all the corners, just a very general lighting, that's what it is. It's like a cloudy day at noon, I think, is what the equivalent is, something like that. guy, we're going to do steel. And a white mask and a generator. The generators are going to be metal edgeware. God, I wish I were making this for a game. Oh wait, I can. Okay, cool. So we have that. Maybe we can grab the same. We grab the same thing. But then we're also going to get a wood. Oh wait, that's like a floor. Nice. There we go. Okay, and then we're going to do... Okay, so that's going to be a wood, right? Very interesting crate. That is exactly what I want. So it's gonna be some sky hammer, baby. Here we go. Cool. We got that. Now we're gonna go to the wood rough. Make sure we sell this bad boy. Maybe I'll It should be very low, yeah. The roughness for rust should be extraordinarily low. So these are bent, yeah, whatever. Again, these aren't close up. So we're gonna go ahead and we don't want unnamed. We just want what we need here. Top down. Take you out. Now we're going to grab the FBX. FBX, well, bam, put it right in there. Bam. Yeah, I mean, it looks like crap. Grab the crate and we just basically rotate it 90 degrees and then we put it exactly where it would be. Grab the main camera, go to 2D. Okay. Hey, banana. Oh, okay. Give me 1 second, I'll be right back. Okay. Shall we? Shall we dance? Cool. Alright. What did I do? Yeah, I was just cutting into these. Okay, so open recent. No, we're gonna open up. New barrel. It was stretching a little bit, so all we're going to do is grab this, get rid of the grain, okay? No grain whatsoever. Okay. Cool. Now, we're going to take that image, we're going to change the canvas size to 70. because I forgot to put one more thing in there. Roll 20. Skyhammer tunnel, bam, turn them off. Boom, lantern. Bam, materials. I think it's just because it's going to be. Yeah. Pretty much the flattening glass. Right there. Alright, and then we're going to go to 2D. Go to main camera. Main camera again is going to be this weird solid green. Just took now. Create image, the canvas two layers. Green, get rid of this green. Then we're going to have to go to layer canvas size. Oh my god. And then 1672. Bam. Put it in the center. Bam. Resize. Bam. Okay. Get rid of that real quick. Layer image size. I'm basically going to do chains here, so that will, do. Okay. Discard those changes. Go into Slack. Okay, barrel, crate, lantern. Stretchiness, auto crop layer. Ah, that's why. Because it will mess with your eyes. Cool, this is pretty sweet. So this is the Roll20 system. it's the online system of tabletop games. I basically made that background there, as you can see, in Unity, and then Nicholas put a grid over it so we could play with it. There's the lines from the walls, there's some rubble, there's some barrels there. There's no real-time shadows, there's nothing really in there yet. We would love to get real-time shadows, I'm not even sure how you would do that. Maybe you probably just mask them out, actually, now I think about it. Probably mask some things out, but yeah. So, made that for Nick so he can go ahead and have a good time with some really basic stuff, and then we'll go on from there as I go more full-time. When I go full-time, I'll dedicate like an entire day of a week to just to do roll 20 stuff. Maybe even 2 days, because I'd like to sell some products on there. I really want to make some stuff for myself as well, and then sell them on Roll20. I actually probably sell them on both 3D models and top-down tabletop pieces. I want to do some like medieval houses. I want to do some taverns. I want to do a tavern. I want to do a giant church. I gotta get like a floor plan for that, and then put all of that together as well. So that's gonna be. Those are pretty big lofty goals, and then I want to throw those in a Unity project. But that is the end of my stream for today. Thank you so much for joining. Pretty sweet. If you haven't followed yet, be sure to follow down below. I will be going full-time in exactly 1 month. Super excited. Right now I can only do about 45 minutes to an hour every morning of the weekday. I also, tonight and Wednesday night, I will be doing 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I will be running through The Witness, which is a video game by Jonathan Blow. It is a puzzle exploration game, which is a fantastic game. It is a nightmare to play for the first maybe 12 hours, and then it becomes like one of the best games you'll ever play. As long as you stick with it. So that's what I'm doing, and then again, 1 month, I'll be doing this a lot more often. I'll be putting up more tutorials. I have one tutorial on YouTube right now. Nicholas has a bunch of EverQuest music, which is fantastic for everybody that loves that. So we are really hitting the ground running here, just making what we love, doing what we love doing, and hopefully you enjoy it and somebody out there enjoys what we do. So it's pretty cool. We're working on Spell Venture. Nicholas has really cool spells. I'm working on a really nice house scene based on some nostalgia from our childhood. And yeah, there's a lot going on. A lot of projects going on. Be sure to follow. And have yourself a really good Monday. Okay. All right. See ya. Thanks for following. Thanks for watching. Bye.